where does the sun always rise from and where does the sun always set? If your answer to these questions is east and west respectively, then congratulations, because your answer is wrong. Sun doesn't always rise in the east, nor does it always set in the west. As a matter of fact, the sun rises from the dead east and sets in the dead west only on 2 days in a year, and that too at your latitude. On all the other 363 days of the year, the sun's rising point is either to the north or to the south of the east. Confused? You should be. The ancient Indian texts call this phenomenon Uttarayan and Dakshinayan. In the next few minutes, we are going to study this concept in detail by using astronomical definitions.
The seasons on Earth are caused by the axial tilt of the Earth. Whenever the Earth's northern hemisphere is tilting towards the sun, it is summer in the north and winter in the southern hemisphere. On the contrary, when the Earth's northern hemisphere is tilting away from the sun, it is winter in the north and summer in the southern hemisphere. So let us try to understand this analytically. The summer solstice is the longest day of the year in the northern hemisphere. It occurs on the 21st or 22nd of June. Once upon a time in the distant past, a festival called Karka Sankranti coincided with the summer solstice. It is called summer solstice because it is summer in the northern hemisphere, as explained in the figure. In Indian astronomy, it is called Vishtumbha. On this day, the sun rises to the northernmost point of the exact east-west line and sets in the northernmost point of the exact east-west line, as can be seen in the figure. Thus, the sun is seen in the northernmost position in the sky. After this day, the sun begins its journey southwards, and this is called Dakshinayana. The word Dakshinayana is composed of two terms. Dakshin means south, and ayana means movement.
As the days pass between 21st June to 22nd September, the sun rises closer and closer to the dead east and sets closer and closer to the dead west, thus moving towards the southern latitude from the summer solstice position. On the 22nd of September, the sun rises exactly in the east and sets exactly in the west, as seen in the figure. This day is called the autumnal equinox or Sharad Sampat in Indian astronomy. If you observe, you can notice the shift in the rising and setting point of the sun on this day from the previous position of 21st June. On this day, the duration of day and night is equal. This day marks the beginning of the autumn in the northern hemisphere and spring in the southern hemisphere of the Earth.
As the Earth moves forward in its orbit, the sun continues its Dakshinayana, that is, its rising and setting point keeps on shifting towards the south of the exact east-west line. On 21st or 22nd of December, it is the shortest day of the year in the northern hemisphere. This day is called the winter solstice or Avashtambha in Indian astronomy. As seen in the figure, the sun rises and sets to its southernmost point from the exact east-west line on this day. This day also marks the beginning of winter in the northern hemisphere and summer in the southern hemisphere. This day marks the end of Dakshinayana. The sun is seen at its southernmost position in the sky. The sun rises and sets to the southernmost point from the exact east-west line. After this day, the sun begins its journey northwards in the sky, and it is called as Uttarayana in Indian astronomy, where Uttara means north and Ayana again means movement. In the distant past, Makara Sankranti coincided with this date, and hence it was also celebrated as a significant festival. We are going to make a separate video on Makara Sankranti in the coming months.
Uttarayan starts on the 22nd of December and the sun continues to move towards the north in the sky. On the 21st or 22nd March, the sun rises directly from the east and sets directly in the west. This day is called vernal or spring equinox, and in Indian astronomy, it is called Vasanta Sampat. If you observe, you can notice the shift in the rising and setting point of the sun from the day on 22nd of December. This day marks the beginning of spring in the northern hemisphere and autumn in the southern hemisphere. On this day, the duration of day and night is equal in the northern hemisphere.
Let's try to understand how the sun moves towards the north and the south by using an animation. As can be seen, the sun reaches the Tropic of Cancer on 21st of June. This date was once celebrated as Karka Sankranti because once upon a time, the sun entered the zodiac of Karka or Cancer on the 21st of June, and hence the name Karka Vrutta or Tropic of Cancer. From 22nd June, it starts moving towards the south, called as Dakshinayan. On the 21st of December, it reaches the Tropic of Capricorn. It was once celebrated as the Makar Sankranti because the sun entered the zodiac of Makara or Capricornus on this day. Hence the name Makara Vrutta or Tropic of Capricorn. The reference to Uttarayan and Dakshinayan can be found in one of the earliest editions of a text named Surya Siddhanta, which has been falsely dated to 580 AD. Surya Siddhanta can be dated to 3000 BCE, and we have a detailed video on the dating of Surya Siddhanta. Check out the video to know more about this fact. The Surya Siddhanta defines Uttarayan as the period between the Makara Sankranti, which currently occurs around 14th of January, and Karka Sankranti, which currently occurs around 16th of July.
अब आप सोच रहे होंगे कि उन्होंने उत्तरायण और दक्षिणायन का फंडा आखिर ढूंढा कैसे? उन्हें कैसे पता चला कि आज सूरज थोड़ा सा उत्तर की तरफ से ऊपर आ रहा है, ना कि पूर्व दिशा की तरफ से? शायद वो गलत भी हो सकते थे। आखिर क्या सबूत हैं कि ये निरीक्षण सिर्फ एक तुक्का नहीं बल्कि एक सोचा समझा ऑब्जर्वेशन है? इसका जवाब छुपा है एक बहुत ही प्राचीन प्रथा में, जिसका नाम था सूर्य अर्घ्य। जी हाँ दोस्तों, सूर्य अर्घ्य जो हमारे पुराणों में और महाभारत में भी लिखा हुआ है, वो सिर्फ एक प्राचीन प्रथा नहीं थी बल्कि वो एक साइंटिफिक मेथड ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन था।
द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ अर्घ्य बिगिंस एट डॉन बिफोर द सन राइजेस एंड इट एंड्स व्हेन द एंटायर डिस्क ऑफ द सन इज विजिबल टुवर्ड्स द ईस्टर्न होराइजन। सो लेट अस से दैट अ कैरेक्टर नेम्ड कर्ण परफॉर्म्स दिस ट्रेडिशन ऑफ सूर्य अर्घ्य एवरी डे विदाउट फेल। Let's say that he starts this tradition from today and there's a tree towards the dead east. Karna performs the Arghya and by the time it ends, the sun's complete disk was visible and it was observed to rise exactly behind the tree on the eastern horizon. Karna performs this tradition religiously every day without fail. However, after a few months, on one fine day, Karna observes something really intriguing. By the time his Arghya ends, he sees that the sun's disk is visible, but it is no longer exactly behind the tree, which it was a few months back. It is now far away and to the left of that tree, which is astronomically speaking towards the north. Karna makes a similar observations almost 6 to 7 months later when the sun's rising point has moved to the right of that tree, which astronomically speaking is towards the south. The distance between the sun's rising point and the dead east was called as Agra, which some references state that it comes from the word Arghya itself. Interesting, isn't it?
The later Siddhantas define the scientific methods of observation of this shift of the sun's rising and setting point by using astronomical instruments. We will discuss this in detail in our videos on Yantras, so make sure to check them out. Till then, stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Pantharas Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Da 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 da